हेलो माय डियर क्लास 12th स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 5th. टॉपिक इज बैंकिंग. दिस इज पार्ट 3rd फ्रॉम योर बुक मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैड टोल्ड यू अबाउट एडवांसिंग लोन. एनी कॉमर्शियल बैंक या एनी फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन दैट एक्सेप्ट डिपॉजिट एंड एडवांस लोन दैट आर कंसिडर्ड एज अ कॉमर्शियल बैंक. सो वी हैड लर्न अबाउट एडवांसिंग लोन. द अनदर फंक्शन इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फंक्शन दैट टाइम दैट वॉज लेफ्ट, दैट इज एक्सेप्टिंग डिपॉजिट्स. सो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट हाउ मेनी टाइप ऑफ डिपॉजिट्स रन बाय द बैंक. So first, a commercial bank accepts deposit from the public and different type of accounts are. So different type of accounts are, first is current account, then saving account, then fixed account. Okay, now it is very very important for your board examination. Okay, 1 marks, it can be asked in 1 marks, 3 marks and in 6 marks. Okay, so remember, from my side, from my point of view, this is very important topic for your student. Okay, now first of all, what do you mean by all the threes? So we are going to learn one by one, so it is very easy. If 6 marks question it is asked, so we have to write a comparative study about all the three. Otherwise, if 3 marks, so it is going to be asked individually. Okay, so let me start it. So what do you mean by current account deposits? Okay, it is also, remember, current account deposits is also known as a demand deposits. It is also known as a demand deposits. Okay student, so remember, it's another name is demand deposit. Okay, now current account deposit are demand deposit. What is this? These are payable on demand, can be withdrawn upon by check without any restriction. If you are having account in any bank, okay, and if you are receiving a check, okay, and anytime when you want, you can withdraw the money, and anytime you want to deposit money, you can deposit money. So this is known as a current account deposit. What is most important? There is no restriction. How many number of time you want to deposit, you can deposit. If you want to withdraw the money, you can withdraw the money. There is no restriction. Okay, so in a one day, in a particular day, you can deposit many number of the time and you can withdraw many number of times. So this is a payable on demand, check is issued for such account. Okay, and there is no restriction, there is no rule for depositing or withdrawing the money. Okay, now interest on the deposit. Remember, for the demand deposit are for the current deposit, no interest is given. Why? Because there is no restriction. Basically, it is used by businessmen. Okay, so businessmen run this account. Okay, they can withdraw any number of time, they can deposit any number of time, because they have to transaction from here to there. Okay, that's why. So for running such account, even bank charges some money, they don't pay any interest. So remember, this is very very important point. So which account we don't get any interest? That is our current account or demand deposit. Okay, now restriction on withdrawal. So there is no restriction. Now statement of account, it is sent at a regular intervals. Okay, now user, who uses this? To businessman. Basically, this account is run by businessman. Now come to the next account, that is saving account. Okay, what is saving account? So these are payable on demand and withdrawal by check. Okay, but there are certain restrictions on number of check issued. Okay, basically we as a household use a saving accounts. Okay, so here check is provided, but you can withdraw money and you can deposit money. There is a rule according to the bank. Okay, here is no rule. Okay, but here is rule. Interest is given, but less than fixed deposit. Okay, interest is given, but less than fixed deposit. Okay, there are limited restriction according to bank rule. Okay, on withdrawal and depositing money, there is a rule ki how much money you can withdraw in a one day. Okay, so such type of restrictions are there. Now, it is send a regular intervals. Okay, so it is also send a regular intervals about your credit, about your debit. Okay, and today is masses facility, so immediately you get masses. Okay, now household and firm. So basically this account is used by household and firms, yani small units that is run by businessman. So they also use this saving account deposit. Okay, now fixed deposits. So these are the deposit for a fixed term. Okay, fixed deposit means what? If the money is deposited, it cannot be withdrawn before the maturity date. So this is what you are going to deposit your money for a fixed duration. It can be for 6 months, it can be for 1 month, it can be for 5 year. Okay, so it is fixed, and before that, matlab before the maturity date, you cannot withdraw money. Okay, and no check is issued for fixed account deposit. It is also known as a time term deposit. Okay, now high rate of interest is given on fixed account deposit. Okay, there are restriction on withdrawal. Money is paid only on maturity. Remember that only on maturity you can withdraw your money. Okay, no statement is given because there is no transactions, no credit, no debit. Just there are two time transaction, when you are depositing money and when you are withdrawing at the time of maturity. So that is why there is no requirement. Now, who run this household and firm? So I think the primary function that is done by the commercial bank is accepting deposit. You are able to understand. So there are three type of account. First is current or demand deposit. That is run by whom? Run by businessman. No interest is paid. Remember, no interest is paid on which? Current or demand deposit. They have to give some charges to run such account. Okay, and remember, most important, there is no rule regulation on withdrawal of money. They can withdraw any time, any number of time. Okay, now saving account deposit. So it is checkable deposit, and current account is also checkable deposit, but there is some limitations for withdrawing the money. Okay, and so this is the basic difference. Okay, and here you get interest. Fixed deposit, there is no check provided, and you cannot withdraw your money before mature. You can only withdraw money at the time of maturity. Okay, so I think you are able to understand it. Okay, now we are going to discuss about credit creation by commercial bank. But today I'm just going to give you introduction of this topic. So proper explanation you are going to get on next video. Okay, so first of all, what is credit creation? I had told you in the money chapter ki there are three supplier of money. How many supplier of money? There are three supplier of money. Okay, so who are the supplier of money? So first is RBI. okay, RBI, what? So it issue all notes. So all notes are issues by RBI. okay, now government. So government issue 1 rupee note. Okay student, and all coins. Okay, now the third is your commercial bank. So what they do, how they supply the money? So they don't print note, they don't issue coins, but how they increase the supply of money? By credit creation, means by giving loan. Okay, how they do? By giving loans. So with the help of the loans, they increases money supply many number of time. Many number of time it increases money supply. How many number of time it increases money supply? It depend upon money multiplier. Okay, it depend upon money multiplier. Okay, So today we are going to just discuss about the meaning of credit creation, some assumptions, some important term, okay, and the equation. Tomorrow I am going to give you working model of this process, credit creation, how the bank do the credit creation. So today is only introductory class, okay. So what do you mean by credit creation? So credit creation refers to the ability to expend deposit as a multiply of its reserve. Okay, whatever initial deposit or primary deposit received by commercial bank, it is going to lend money many more times. So how many more times, how multiple? So it depend upon money multiplier. So this is simply the meaning of credit creation that you have to note it, and it is very very important from my side. Okay, so what do you mean by credit creation? So it refers to the ability to expend deposit as a multiple of it reserve. Okay, now next is commercial bank are able to create credit which is many times more than the deposit received by banks. How many number of times they are able to create money? So it depend upon money multiplier. And how you are going to calculate it? So money multiplier is equal to 1 upon LRR. So here we are going to understand these term. So what do you mean by initial deposit? So initial or primary deposit means what? The deposits of household and sorry, here is firm. Okay, this is by mistake. Firms held by the bank are called primary deposits. Whatever money saved in commercial bank, that is considered as an initial deposit. Okay, now legal reserve ratio. What do you mean by legal reserve ratio? So it is the fraction of deposits of commercial bank which is legally compulsory for the commercial bank to keep in the form of cash reserve ratio and liquidity assets, statutory liquidity ratio, SLR, CRR. Okay, so in detail, what do you mean by CRR? What do you mean by SLR? We are going to discuss it in proper way when we are going to learn about central bank and its function. Okay, so just here what you have to keep in mind, initial deposit, whatever money is saved in the bank, that is known as a initial, saved by the household in the bank, that is considered as a initial deposit. Okay, every bank have to keep some amount of its reserve. Okay, that is considered as a legal reserve ratio. Now two assumptions. So whenever you are going to learn about credit creation, so there are two basic assumptions. First is the entire commercial banking system is one unit and is termed as a bank. Okay, so here we are going to consider all commercial bank as a one unit, means there is no SBI, Punjab National Bank, okay, Bank of Baroda, no, all the banks is considered as a one. And which term we are going to use? Banks, B-A-N-K-S. Okay, next, all receipt and payment in the economy are routed through the banks. Remember, there is no cash transaction. Okay, so remember this, all the payment, if you want to have a drink, yeah, you want to have a cup of a coffee in a restaurant or in a dhaba, you have to pay in by the account. Okay, there is no cash payment. Remember, it is minor value or it is a big amount of money, any type of money, any amount of money. If there is transacted, so it is only transacted through banking system. Okay, there is no cash payment. Okay, now total money creation. I had told you na ki whatever deposits is done by household and firm, bank creates many more time in compared to its initial deposit. So how many more times? It depend upon money multiplier. So the equation by which we are able to calculate how much money creation is done by the commercial bank is this. Okay, total money creation is equal to initial deposit 1 upon LRR. And we can write it, money multiplier is equal to 1 upon LRR, and then we can use this equation, initial deposit ya primary deposit multiply by money multiplier. So this are this one give you same equation. Okay, so these are the two way to find out total money creation, that is done by the bank with the help of initial deposit and legal reserve ratio. Okay, thank you for today. Tomorrow we are going to discuss in detail. Okay, and there is a request, please read your book once so that you are able to understand what is your doubt before my lecture. Okay, so please try to understand yourself, read at least your book and then listen the video. No doubt you are able to understand. All of you are very good in your study. Okay, so for today this much only. Okay student, thank you.